We've got Rocket League, CSGO, Street Fighter, and Rainbow Six. You're watching The Podium. G'day gamers, and welcome to The Podium, where we take a look at the biggest hits, epic takedowns, and classic comebacks from the world of eSports. I am joined, as always, by Mr. Job Gilroy.
And I'm joined by Mr. Bo Uche.
Yes, that's me. We are joined by each other.
Yeah, I guess. You looked at me like I'd forgotten your name. He's remembered my name.
It's written right here on the screen. So, another great weekend of action from across the world of eSports, and we're focusing on what's happening in Australia and New Zealand, and there's been a really great Rocket League match over the weekend.
Yeah, there was. There was an awesome one. I said it was going to be one to watch. Darksider versus the Chiefs. The Chiefs put together the reverse sweep.
Good old reverse sweep.
Exactly. Darksider were up by two in the best of five series, and the Chiefs needed three games in a row just to keep their unbeaten streak alive. Darksider desperately needed to beat the Chiefs to secure the second seed for the season. And if you watch the highlights, Drupe dashes Darksider's chances. It's a bit rough.
Yeah, swinging in at the end there. Just check it out.
Drupe goes up for the ball. It's a light response from Darksider. Drupe now the one to react onto the ball. Dumbo, an easy save, but Jake is back in with the cross over to Torsos. The corner, the read is so good off this backboard. Darksider just lucky to be alive after that.
And touch after touch against the backboard, against the sidewall, against that corner is forcing Darksider into difficult positions where they can't get this clear.
They want them out of the net, so the Chiefs are going to continue to get these plays off. The pass again. Drupe angles that one to the minute degree.
That was inevitable. Drupe rolling that in because Chiefs had just put on a display of attacks.
One all. The Chiefs can never be counted out.
And there you go. Fantastic goal there by Drupe.
Yeah, and the first of many. It was just they were just switching back on, the Chiefs. It was about time. They maybe, I don't know, coast a little bit against Darksider, but realized that they couldn't. It was good. It was good stuff.
Yeah, great action from the Rocket League. So next up, we have the IEM qualifiers, a tournament which had a lot of success down under last year, and we're seeing some great action over the weekend this year.
Yeah, so IEM Sydney's less than a month away now, and I guess, you know, all the Aussie teams are the last ones left to be decided. Only three teams will make it in, and two have actually locked in their spots, the first of which is Grayhound Gaming, and it was a fantastic series of matches from them. They're such a powerful team. They've got, you know, they seem to have it all locked in. And they managed to put together, watch this clip and you'll see what they...
Yep. You'll see exactly what we're talking about.
And it's a B-rush coming in and Malta, he'll have called this. He hasn't quite found the first kill. The Molly will help out though.
Yeah, this time some better counter utility out from Greyhound Legacy, not able to get that good flash onto the Toxic Barrels player, but yellow stat blitz all stepping up with a frag here for Legacy. And it comes down to the last two remaining players for Greyhound once more. It looked like it was going to be a good hold, but Malta just peeking his head up above the barrels a little bit too early. And in the end, now Legacy once more on the site, planting that bomb in a very advantageous position. Urcast, though, very cheeky. Does get rid of yellow.
Would have loved to deny the bomb plant, though. That's what he was going for. Couldn't quite find it, but grab. That's a great line on Lonsdale.
Legacy's now giving them openings, and that's not what you can give to Greyhound. No. I talked about this in the first half after Urcast got the one versus three, and Gratisfaction gets three there as well for Greyhound.
There you have it. Greyhound putting on a clinic there with that triple kill.
Gratisfaction, you know, he played above and beyond. It was fantastic to watch, and it was enough to stop Legacy from, you know, doing what it looked like they might be able to do. They've been looking pretty good this weekend.
Yeah. And, of course, that wasn't all that we saw from IEM over the weekend. There was another match which got your attention.
The other team to qualify for IEM Sydney already is the Chiefs. And this was a little bit unexpected. They're a real Cinderella story. I mean, the Chiefs were the team that went to IEM Sydney last year. And they weren't expected to go again this year. They've had some roster changes. You know, they were a little bit discovered. Tux is the only remaining member of the Chiefs team after Malta left to go to Greyhound. Right. So yeah, it wasn't expected, but they managed to do it, and it was thanks to the Malta's replacement APOC, who he played amazingly. It was spectacular. Check out them wrapping up their slot at IEM here.
All it takes now is for the Chiefs to negotiate this round successfully. It is well and truly in their grasp. They found that first pick as well onto Hats. They've got into the B site they go. A tough retake for Order, for sure.
Before the bomb even goes down, it's a tough retake because the Chiefs are all over the site. They're also holding the flank with Tux, and he will pick up Alistair, 3v5.
It's impossible right now for Order. Surely the Molotovs come in to connector. The Chiefs, 5v3. They've completely locked the CTs out of the bomb site. And what does Order even have to retake with? Two smokes? An MP9 and two CZs. How is this possible right now for Order to even get in and get the retake going? The Chiefs, all they're doing is closing out the round as they should be. It's probably going to be 5-3, and this is one round away. That's it. The Chiefs, they've done it, Tim. I do not think I would be saying that today. But 2-0 over Order. The Chiefs are now through to IEM Sydney.
And there you have it. Great to see the Chiefs getting up on that one.
Yeah, 2 years in a row. It's awesome.
Yeah. Now we head over to the CyberGamer Premier League for some Street Fighter action.
Yeah, the CGPL Street Fighter Grand Finals were last week, and it was some awesome action. I love seeing fighting games, you know, on such a professional setting, and yeah, this was done really well. The final matchup was between Somniac and ROF, and I've actually spoken to ROF before. Somniac is like his white whale. He can never seem to beat him, and that happened again. He sent him into the loser's brackets. ROF sent Somniac to the loser's brackets, only to face off against him in the grand finals. And Somniac, he's too good.
Life about even for both of these players. Somniac is sitting on B-Trigger as it's only two bars in B-Trigger 2. Manages to scuff him out there as well. Dash forward, Maroth just playing that keypad game. Doesn't want anything to do. Doesn't want to guess, and a big boot's going to come through. The second one, not kidding, but the banana peel now is going to be that insurance policy. And ROF, one hit away from getting his B-Trigger as well.
I like that. ROF using the banana peel just to slow down the pace of the match. He realized the Somniac was getting a bit too trigger happy. His V-Trigger activated, but now we see full critical art on the deck for ROF. And he has the V-Trigger. So many EX bars. EX Dolphin Dive, not going to take it just yet. But living on a prayer now. It's Somniac and the overhead to take it. Tying it up. One game apiece.
Roth managing to pull it back there.
Yeah, so don't call him Ishmael. You said he was his white whale.
Oh, I get it.
Now, to keep those guns blazing, we're heading over to the Rainbow Six Premier League APAC Final.
Yeah.
Which saw a bit of an interesting outcome with one of those matches.
Yeah, so, there's been an interesting weekend for Australian Rainbow Six. So the team that eventually would come out on top was Fnatic, but up until last Friday, they weren't called Fnatic. They were Mind Freak. And Mind Freak represented Australia at the Six Invitational earlier this year. They were acquired by Fnatic, and they demonstrated that a change in jersey wasn't enough to slow them down. Let's have a look.
I'm getting a bit worried because Fnatic, this might be the first round they take in a while, and something they absolutely need. They're all rotating around the main lobby. They're all putting this pressure on the Aces. They just need to deny the plant here, and then that can be the round for Fnatic.
First Gas Babe's going to go out. There's still two more and so much time, but the thing is, with this Blitz, they're just going to rush on in. Neo is prepared to receive, and Lunar Metal goes down, but the rest of Cryptic are still in a position to make this happen. Gas Babe's going to come out. Diffuser comes out. 2v4. 3v4 retake. Whoa! Rizraz gets the first kill. Is Aces just going to stick this defuse? He's got to stick it. Quantic managed to do it last time. Cryptic have to get this. Neo is the bait. There's no one to kill him. Is Aces going to get it? And the second round in a row, a stealth defuse.
Nothing like a change of strip to invigorate a team, am I right?
Ah, exactly. You know, just, dressing up, fashion souls stuff. That stealth defuse was something else as well. I mean, it happened two rounds in a row, which is goofy as hell.
Yeah. So what's the best strategy against a stealth defuse? Because I know you've used this strategy yourself in the past.
If you want to stop it from happening, just be better at the video game. So that's roughly what you need to do.
Yes. Joe will be having intensive training courses online after this, where you too can learn how to be a better Rainbow Six player. There you have it, folks. Another great round of action from across the world of esports in our region. But that's not all. There's always more action to come. What's on your radar for this week?
There's always more eSports. This week, the Rocket League, I'm going back to it again. Darksided have to play through the playoffs. They're facing off against Tainted Minds. They're looking for a spot in the finals, and that way they'll get to play against the best in Australia again. It's going to be fantastic. They're going to leave it all out on the, car soccer pitch. Of course, the IEM Sydney qualifiers continue. There is still one spot left for an Australian team to get to IEM Sydney, and it's between Legacy and Order, and they're not going to let it go easy.
Yeah, and if this week's action's anything to go by, it's going to be another great weekend. So tune in and check it out, and we'll be here next week to cover it all for you and fill you in on all the greatest hits from the week. We leave you now with a bit of competitive Fortnite action. See you next week.
The workers are continually building, constructing magnificent arches, vaults, and corridors. Each worker places its pellet of mud in a position demanded by a master plan, though how they're able to do so, we don't begin to understand. They store their food, dead wood, in special chambers throughout the nest. Wood is very hard to digest, but they extract the most from it by first eating it, and then cultivating a fungus on their dung, which extracts more of the nutriment. They then eat the fungus. So these spires and turrets are key elements in an air conditioning system of a near-perfect mansion that has stout walls to protect its inhabitants from the elements and from their enemies. But that is of no consequence.